light candles for my Darren. As long as they do that, nothing new will happen.
Nothing new
will happen if they have to turn their backs on that.
But don't you?
If they, you know, adoration will produce imitation.
Adoration.
Or brackage. Oh, brackage. Come on. Shit on brackage.
Hey, Sandy, just what did you do? Hey, Sandy, just what did you do? In the college square, they were standing there with the flag and with the drum. And the whispered word as the young ones stirred was, now at last they've come. And the air was still with the lonely thrill of, now the hour is near. And the smell of sweat was better yet than the awful stench of fear. Hey Sandy, why were you the one? All the years of growing up are wasted now and gone. Did you see them turn? Did you feel the burn of the bullets as they flew? Hey Sandy, just what did you do? Hey Sandy, just what did you do? Through the air the shout as you all ran out was, why are these things done? And you stood and you stared, but no one cared for another campus bum. And your songs were dead and the hymns instead were to the burning pyre. And the words of youth like love and truth, just ashes in the fire. Hey Sandy, why were you the one?
I'd unravel every riddle for any individual in trouble or in pain.
With the thoughts you'd be thinking, you could be another Lincoln if you only had a brain.
Oh, I could tell you why the ocean's near the shore. I could think of things I never thought before, and then I'd sit and think some more. I would not be just a nothing, my head all full of stuffing, my heart all full of pain.
If I could suddenly feel and to know once again that what I feel is real, I could cry, I could smile, I might lay back for a while. Tell me what would I do if I could feel? What would I do if I could reach inside of me and to know how it feels to say, but that's the whole tragic point, my friends. What would I do if I could feel?
I was young. I was surviving the times, waiting for my moment, I was destined to shine. Lil Ray had an NXX, I was hoping I'm next, wanting bracelets, never had a rope on my neck, unless I was holding Ty-A chain, rest in peace. Even though that night you flipped on us, you warned us, if you came back and we still in the corners, we goners.
And make your head explode. Tuna on toast. Nothing's ever worked out for me with tuna on toast. I want the complete opposite of tuna on toast. Chicken salad on rye. Untoasted with a side of potato salad and a cup of tea.
Well, there's no telling what can happen from this.
You know, chicken salad's not the opposite of tuna. Salmon's the opposite of tuna, because salmon swim against the current, and the tuna swim with it.
Good for the tuna.
George.
It was very much an initiatory performance in the food art genre. But early on, this lunch was actually based, as most of my performances are, in what I'm actually doing during my day. The sandwich identical lunch is a tuna fish sandwich on wheat toast with lettuce and butter, no mayo, and a cup of soup or a glass of buttermilk.
This would enable a completely different understanding of what film would be like and what it would do. And I thought, in terms of long durations, because I've loved long durations, and I love long durations in music, I loved long durations in performance, I loved long durations in relationships too. Yeah, and so I thought I should make a film that just beggars Andy Warhol's 24-hour long film. I'll make one that'll last 50 years. But how? Because you can't make a film that lasts 50 years using the normal materials, because they aren't like us. You see, I'm almost getting there. It's 38 years and rolling. Yeah, 38 and going. But I know I'm not doing that great, but okay. But a projector or a film that ran for 50 years, it would wear out. It just wouldn't last. You can't do it. You just can't do it. You have to have a completely different conceptual stratagem. So my idea was to actually paint the emulsion on and then let the film take its own course over time. But it needs to do things very slowly, very slowly. And I imagined that this kind of cheap house paint that I used would actually turn yellow and disintegrate and fall off, and all the things that would happen with aging would happen to it in a very, very, very slow way. But, I mean, of course, they probably happen to the other artwork, but those artworks aren't movies. This is a movie.
Hey, Dubois, quel café, puce K, call labor, eat a parmieu.
Every little thing is going to be all right. And that's God bless, and that's Robbie Lawyer. I just want to read something out because we have an alternative view. It's always good to get alternative views on this one. The Equality Bill is a good thing, and this is from Portia De Rossi. It says, I don't think that this country we have any kind of tolerance. For proof, simply admit to someone that you're a Christian and see how differently they treat you. We have to get back to where we once belonged. I read the news today and oh boy, it's reminiscent of when the English army had just won the war. And through in seeing where we are now, the news is rather sad. I just had to laugh, seeing the photograph of the cross around the necks of the soldiers, clutched the palms of those heroes too. I'd love to all of you on to God in the manner that was familiar to those beautiful men of yesteryear. And that's God bless and keep up the good fight. But yeah, exactly. I mean, just got a.
Me, I'm the walkway. Lead me to the building. Fuck you. 5643. Yeah, right. You're some stupid bitch. Who paid for that floor? Not me. No way. Never pay for no floor ever again. Not once, not never. Nope. Whose chair is that? Who bought that goddamn chair here? It's not my chair. Not my chair, not my problem. That's what I say. No way. Stupid dresses. Stupid flowers. Lighthouses rule. You don't like the lighthouse? You suck. What is this, seahorse captain? What is this, seahorse seashell party? Who didn't invite me? Why didn't I get invited, seahorse seahell? What is this? Get real. I'm in love with seahorses. I'm in love with them. They're so beautiful and cute. I'm in love with the seahorses. They're fucking unreal. I love them. They're like all the clocks. I love them. I love seahorses, and I love looking at them, and I love seashells. I love seashell things. I love things with seashells and seahorses on them, like blankets and towels and little bags. I love them. Seahorses. Forever.
Obviously. So this...
Woof! 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 Not enough content!
Now there's too much!
Just right.
Soupy's on tour. Juice wanted to be seen. Lament disc turning. Soupy's on tour! Soupy's on tour!
Madeleine, imagine que c'est écrit comme Astor, la cigarette de l'homme moderne.
Hang low, which makes me feel like I've got to go in and out of the shower with some real-time power. Oh, 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 oh. Now I never saw them at all until there was you. Why do birds suddenly appear whenever you are near? Oh, why do birds, why do they suddenly appear whenever you are near? Just like me, they long to be a part of yours. Why do shower songs always feel like they're not too long and they're not too short? It's true, they're just the right length. Duration, celebration, tradition, so many things that end with T-I-O, and we believe that the stars all around us, their little clocking suns. For the rest of this world.
But they brought me back.
What happened while you were dead?
I left my body and floated free.
Were you lying on a bed?
Yes, I was gazing down at me. It's an awesome feeling of inner peace and happiness. A euphoric feeling, such joy I feel inside.
Keep on talking, tell me more.
I saw beings who looked wise.
Please continue, I implore.
My life flashed before my eyes.
What question did they ask you?
Tell us what you've learned from living.
Your reply, your point of view.
I've been taking without giving. It's an awesome feeling of inner peace and happiness. A euphoric feeling, such joy I feel inside. Dink a 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 dink 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 a dink 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 a dink a dink 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 the joy I feel inside.
Brush Hogs is what everybody else on the railroad calls people from Girden, and they may be going to close down the line and we may have to move on. So endangered species.
Hi, everybody. I bet you're wondering where the menu is. In fact, some of you might be wondering if this is the menu. Hey, stop that. That's not funny. Where was I? Right, menus.
Happened again.
What happened?
Yeah.
I'll ask the questions. What happened?
I just stomped some pigeons in the park. They didn't move.
All right, let's change the subject. You and Jerry dated for a while. Tell us, what was that like? That's wrong card.
I don't get these birds. They're breaking the deal. It's like the pigeons decided to ignore me.
So they're like everyone else.
All right, let's take a short break. Okay, we're back.
When in Chicago, don't forget to visit Hall Walls, too. That's HALLWALLS 2, located in the middle of 400 South Peoria, right there on the third floor. HALLWALLS 2 shows both the hottest talent and the coolest talent. Openings occur Monday mornings, perfect for the guys and gals and pals on the go. That's HALL Hall, WALL Wall, S 2. At 400 South Peoria, at 3111 on the third floor, Chicago, Illinois.
These are perfect examples of someone saying 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 these are perfect examples. I'm going on break now.
America. America, I've given you all, and now I'm nothing. America, $2.27, January 17th, 1956. I can't stand my own mind. America, when will we end the human war? Go fuck yourself with your atom bomb. I don't feel good. Don't bother me. I won't write my poem till I'm in my right mind. America, when will you be angelic? When will you take off your clothes? When will you look at yourself through the grave? When will you be worthy of your million Trotskyites? America, why are your libraries full of tears? America, when will you send your eggs to India? I'm sick of your insane demands. When can I go into the supermarket and buy what I need with my good looks?
Go fuck yourself with your atom bomb. Well, I wouldn't see no cause for alarm if you jerk yourself off. Oh, well, you know you could go over the hill and into the wood. You know it's not very nice to kill so many. Will you go away if I give you a penny? What's bothering you? Are you some kind of nut? Hey, go get laid, try to come to the cut. Oh, what's the matter with you? Did you dead at your guts? Do you think you're strange, that you're some kind of nut?
Mike, what are the neighbors gonna
think? What are you doing? Mike, that isn't in the script. Mike, what are you doing with that plug? No, Mike, no. Don't pull the plug. No. No, my God, oh no.
This is Mike's house. Mike's got a nice house. Open up the front door, a city scene. But hey, there's more than just one view from Mike's house. Going back through Mike's house, what happened to the urban? The scene has turned suburban. So let's go meet Mike, see what Mike's like. Hey, that must be
darn this TV.
On Mike's location makes all the TV stations get horrible reception. He needs a new connection. Mike heard about cable, he read about cable, thought about cable.
Gotta have cable.
Now he's got cable, he's trying out the cable. Hey, that can't be.
I'm on TV.
Mike's life, Mike's show, Mike's life, Mike's show, Mike's life, Mike's show. Mike's life, Mike's show. Mike's like my show.
No, no,
my
Mike,
show?
No, no.
How'd I ever get into this mess?
But I really can't stay. I'm actually off to the post office to pick up a package. I think it's another book from my book club. And, that's right, I read. What, is that so startling? I happen to think there's a lot more to life than just watching television. You can read about it, too. Did you know that? That's why I belong to the Television Biography Book of the Month Club. The TVBBOTMC. I'm sure you've heard of it. And, let's take a look.
This is the theme to Gary's show. The theme to Gary's show. Gary called me up and asked if I would write his theme song. I'm almost halfway finished. How do you like it so far? How do you like the theme to Gary's show? This is the theme to Gary's show. The opening theme to Gary's show.
Gary Show. This is the music that you hear as you watch the credits. We're almost to the part of where I start to whistle. Then we'll watch It's Gary Shandling Show. This was the theme to Gary Shandling Show.
This is my favorite one. This is Desi, a book. And you know they're making a movie out of this, and it's going to be called Desi, a Book.
I think I'm better than Chuck Swirsky, freaking liberal. Oh, Jesus. Oh, yeah. Catch the wave.
Bonkshus or
no, no, sir, obviously your elderly grandmother is the problem, because that's what this week's show is about.
Yeah, but I'm watching the show right now.
Idiots! It's simple! Look at this! This is what's airing right now, the Pet Care Show! Listen, I'm talking about pets!
Stop calling about racism! We did that a week ago! Look! Here! Listen to me for the last time. Crime on the streets happened last week. Everything I'm saying happened last week. Look! Here! And that concludes our first show, Crime in the Streets. I can't help but think it would have gone a little better had somebody actually called in, but I guess that's because you won't see me until next week. Oh well, as soon as we get the kinks worked out here, I'm sure it's going to be a great, great show.
Thank you for watching The Convoluted Network. And now the set.
Now, do you find critics more receptive to your work than now you are the best artist?
No, that's actually the why I say that I'm the best artist, because the critics will not touch me with a 10-foot pole. They are afraid of what I might do to the world of art.
You know any other best artists besides yourself, or other people that you can consider also, or you are the best of the best?
No, the main person that I actually admire a lot and have studied continuously is Leonardo da Vinci, because I seem to be, you know, this sounds pretentious, I know, but it looks as though I have some sort of a parallel line with the same way that he was, and I am as eclectic in creating as he is. And that's one of the reasons why it made me say I think he was the greatest of them all.
What the hell is this? Must be a cartoon. Shh. What? Must be Bythe. This looks like Bythe. I remember when I was a boy in Russia, it was biology. It was Bythe. Oh, it's born. Whatever it is, it's born. Look out! Too late. It's dead already.
May I help you?
Sure, I'll have a cheeseburger, man.
Cheeseburger macaroni? Well, that's our specialty.
Don't know what to do with hamburger? Try Hamburger Helper Cheeseburger Macaroni. It'll turn plain hamburger into a hearty, delicious meal that'll please your coolest customer.
Hamburger Helper Helper.
Hey, that was great, man. Give me five.
Would you settle for four?
Make a great meal.
If you wanted to talk about the elderly, you should have called last week when our pet care show was airing, but we were taping the elderly show.
The words are coming back
on top of me.
The words are spilling out of my head and then returning into my ear. It puts a distance between the words and their apprehension
or their comprehension.
The words coming back seem slow.
They don't seem to
have the same forcefulness as when I speak them.
I think it's also slowing me down. I think that it makes my thinking slower.
I have a double take on myself. I am once removed from myself. I am thinking and hearing.
I think it's important that I do this in a very coherent way. So I'm going to try to be as logical and concrete and specific as I can in order to avoid generalizations. I mean a residual substructure of affect that would be homologous or equivalent to the ultimate destination of dialectic if it weren't for the fact that its own inner laws appear to be generated by the lexical indices of a kind of ontological pre-existent. And, of course, by the inevitable paradigms of postmodernist capitalism. The epitaxial fricatives located in the ruptured rhetorical spasms of a conjoined systematic imperative are not, therefore, the locus vivendi of a parasyntactic concourse, nor are they even sly reminders of bourgeois affinities. They are, in fact, substrategized dislocations of trans-ischemic discourse, unarguably enjambed in protemic lepsis and inextricably emblematic of classic struggle. While hermeneutic gestures posited by an essentially tautological regrounding of cathectic instantiation may be hopelessly déclassé, we must reject the abysmal supplicate nod in the direction of a revisionist post-disenfranchised ideological anomaly. Without a propedeutic gesture lexically inflamed, we are doomed to a feeble resuscitation of pathetic fallacy, an unideological dictum mori, save sundry arcane pledged redemptions, a proto-ingot ergo non says a fetid planar gobo, but wallow bins a shanty tiver dollop co poons a prisbet merkly sconce idia colo pirkly maidia farfa presse bundo hoit di charcatush ge icatos de mandoquar idoqua ina gestro con par i retino qua c'ho una va far che non capa histo io go da tender co die ide i da ricondo cap i ide in da cote ti riada ca uno kis ria go da
piazza ma scorso men da rompo la faccia do si pazzo.
Who are you?
I'm fine, thanks. Who are you?
I'm fine too, but you can't come in unless you give the password.
Oh, what is the password?
Oh, no, you gotta tell me. Hey, I tell what I do, I give you three guesses. It's the name of a fish.
Is it Mary?
Ha ha! That's an old fish.
She isn't. Well, she drinks like one. Let me see. Is it Sturgeon?
Hey, you're crazy. Sturgeon, he's a doctor who cuts you open when you're sick. Now, I give you one more chance.
I got it. Haddock.
That's funny. I got a haddock, too.
What do you take for a haddock?
Well, now, sometimes I take aspirin, or sometimes I take a calomel.
Say, I'd walk a mile for a calomel.
You mean chocolate calomel. I like that, too, but you know, guess it. Hey, what's the matter? You don't understand English? You can't come in here unless you say swordfish. Now, I'll give you one more guess.
Swordfish. I think I got it. Is it swordfish?
That's it. You guess it.
Pretty good, huh?
Fine. You guess it.
What do you want?
I
want
to come in.
What's the password?
Oh, you're no fool of me. Swordfish.
No, I got tired of that. I changed it.
What's the password now?
Gee, I forgot it. I better come outside with you.
Hey, here comes my pop. Hey, Pinky, you know the password?
Get up. That's no way to go in and speak easy. That's the way you come out.
Is the flirtatiously fun dance progressions designed to flatten your abs, thin your hips and thighs, plus lift and firm your booty, all while you're just having fun moving and dancing to the music.
It is just a blast. You're having a great time. You don't even know you're working out.
It is just so much fun.
And now, for only $19.99, you can have the hot new Flirty Girl Fitness DVD, Booty Beat, featuring super sexy fat-burning routines from your favorite music videos.
You're doing this dance and you're feeling so sexy while you're doing it, and your body just changes.
But it gets even better. Call now and you can have this amazing DVD for only $9.99. Plus, we'll also include a free bonus DVD, the Flirtatiously Fun Chair Dance. Altogether, this is a $40 value, yours right now for only $9.99.
Go, you Packers, go!
Drinks. Your stock.
Can you cash a check for $15.22?
Sure. $5, $10, $15, and $22.
Thanks. As soon as I get a check for $15.22, I'll send it to you. Swordfish!
Trunk Show gets the best artists like Eric Fleischhauer, Asaf Evren, Jody Mack, Deborah Stratman, Ollie Watt, Lauren Anderson, Brandon Alvendia, and the best partners like J.T. Baker, Tusk, the Hyde Park Arts Center, and the Nightingale Cinema, and puts a sticker right on your darn bumper and right in your dang heart. Trunk Show, monthly shows, snacks, stickers. Trunk Show, street art for the blooper reel of the American Empire.
Unleash your style, make a girl smile, it's worth your while, anything's possible. Unleash good style, make a girl smile, it's worth your while, anything's possible.
I'm sick of your insane demands. When can I go into the supermarket and buy what I need with my good looks?
Answer the telephone. Put a number 4 on what you would touch.
Hello? Hello?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Hello? Yes?
Yeah?
Hello.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello, Felix.
Hello?
Hello, Dave? Hello? Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello, Janie?
Listen, you...
Feels like flying. I close my eyes. Oh God, I think I'm falling.
Oh, we're all fine. How are you? Oh, Jeff, darling, where are you?
Darling, it's me.
What?
The girl's dead.
Are you sure you have a positive ID?
No, not exactly.
I'm so confused.
I told you not to call here.
Yes, I know, I know.
I haven't been able to think or concentrate on anything except you.
I see. And what happened?
What makes you think it was me?
This is Carissa. I just called to tell you I think you're a real creep. Larry, I'm just kidding. Listen, I thought your performance at the talent show was really funny. I can hardly wait to see it on TV. Anyway, I'm having a party Saturday night. Would you like to come and act like Olivia?
Are you kidding? Well, how about that? John Wayne, here, Mom. Here's John Wayne. Yo.
I can't believe it. I've never been on the set before.
Hey.
Hello, Mom. Hello, Utah. You work for the news?
No, actually, I work for Extra.
Hey, I'm lucky I came on to you. I'm an impersonator.
Yeah? Okay, my man, go for it.
What, right now?
You bet.
Well, let's see here. Here's a little bit of the old John Wayne for you.
You know, I've always kind of had a feeling that deep down, one reason why I don't give the interviews is that even though you're obviously much at home on a stage with thousands of people yelling, way underneath all that glitter and gold and everything else, kind of a shy Elvis. Are you?
Well, yeah, I'll tell you. You know, back in high school, I was kind of like the shy guy in my class, you know? Then I became a singer, and I'll tell you something. When I get up on that stage, some people say they don't recognize me. I'm a different person. When I get up on that stage, I want to just sing, I want to dance around, and I just feel completely different. It's really good.
Well, I'll tell you something out there in TV land. I'm hamming it up. I'll tell you. So, anyway, man, I can't believe it on television, really.
Where you're from, Beaver?
Yeah, I'm from Beaver. Yeah, yeah.
Can you do any more imitations?
Do you know Rocky? Sylvester Stallone?
Yeah, do that one.
Well, let me tell you something out there, TV land. I just made the two, and it just tickles the heck right out of me. Wow.
God. Uh-oh. Damn it.
God. You think it's ruined?
Trying to get the bugs out of this thing all morning.
This is Carissa. I just called to tell you I think you're a real creep. Larry, I'm just kidding. Listen, I thought your performance at the talent show was really funny. I can hardly wait to see it on TV. Anyway, I'm having a party Saturday night. Would you like to come and act like Olivia?
Until we get it right, you and me. Born at the age of zero to two parents, Jack Rollins was instantly enamored of the filmmaking process. Even as a boy, he was seen walking around fields, speaking to himself, pretending to be talking to a camera. Luckily, his parents foresaw the genius and saw the true glimmer of brilliance within these child neuroses. And they sent him off to filmmaking school at the age of four. It paid off.
Jack Rollins. That's my name. That's who I am. I'm Jack Rollins, you know, I mean, Jack Rollins, you know, I mean, and that's who I am. I mean, I'm Jack Rollins, you know, Jack Rollins, Jack, you know.
Give me a J. E.
The moments in which Zinedine Zidane gave Marco Materazzi a headbutt during the final of the 2006 Soccer World Cup grew into a popular meme. Hundreds of authors proposed variations of the iconic incident. Similar to the Many Worlds theory by quantum physicist Hugh Everett, originally published in 1957, a multiplicity of realities coexist. Same, same, but different. The multiverse is composed of a quantum superposition of infinitely many, increasingly divergent, non-communicating parallel universes or quantum worlds. There is no there there. Aesthetics and linguistic practice move beyond mere dichotomies toward a state in which the conditions of a word as a phonetic particle and a semantic wave exist at the same time.
Virgil steals to pay for cello lessons, and although he does not achieve greatness on the instrument, he is soon good enough to play in a local band.
The Oslo with the swastika tattoo, there is a vacancy waiting in the... I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen, there's no reason to do this song here.
Radio.
I was tuning in the shine of the light, not die.
With anchor person Cynthia Bell.
Good evening. It's Thursday, August 17th, and here are the people and places making the news tonight. A 7.3 earthquake ripped through Nogales, Mexico this morning, killing over 315 people. And let's slow it down, Cynthia. And turn. Day four. in the Stimney Brothers trial ended with defense team members deadlocked over the issue of putting up the wrong graphic behind Cynthia. Judge Giacchetti ordered the prosecution to pay attention to the teleprompter and not the voice in the earpiece. Jurors were reminded to stop saying what I'm saying. Unbelievable. Heavy rains in the Northeast have caused a passenger train derailment, and the sandwiches are here in Klamath Falls, Oregon. Transit officials have determined that I got the ham with Munster and no dressing. Amtrak spokesman Robert Coleslaw stated, "They only sent over one large fries, let's split them." The White House, wrong camera, that's the one, hosted emissaries from third world countries in an attempt to gather information about her nose. What's with her nose? See it twitching? She looks like a rabbit. No, more like bewitched. I missed it. There it goes again. Do you suppose she's going to sneeze? Wait, I think she just repeated our entire conversation. Face forward, Cynthia. Shut up, stop talking, and maybe she'll return to the teleprompter. That's the news. We'll be back with Science and EnviroWatch right after these messages, and this new girl sucks.
Now, write your first name and your last name at the bottom of the picture. Now, put your pencils down.
I resolve nothing except to drink more and get that little cartoon published in the New Yorker, perhaps surrounded by some long feature on Liberia or pummeled by a Mavis Gallant story.
Walk down by the bathing pond to try and catch some sun. Saw at least 100 schoolgirls sobbing into handkerchiefs as one. I don't believe they knew I was a schoolboy.